You're not there every single day, and when you are there, it's not the whole day either. So you can plan your work around your timetable. So I knew my first semester, I did 2.5 days and then had the rest of the whole week off to study, work, and do a little bit of self-care. We've got a timetable planner online. You can go in and you can play with your timetable, try and figure out what's going to work best for you and your schedule. Whether that's, you know, if you've got kids and you need to pick them up in the afternoon, try and have your classes during the middle of the day. And yeah, you do have the option of doing part-time or full-time as well. So full-time, 4 courses, and then part-time would be less than that. If you do part-time, the degree is obviously going to take that a little bit longer.
There's a tuition fee and then a SAF fee, and that's all stuff that you can defer off and get covered with a government loan. I'm paying for it now. It just comes out of my pay fortnightly. I actually don't even realise that it's coming out. It comes out just with your pay, just generally. I think it's about $80 a fortnight or something like that that I pay now. Some people do pay their fees straight up, which is another way that you can do it if that's what you're able to do. But I just needed to really offset my costs as well. So it was the same with my husband with his apprenticeship. He deferred his costs as well. So if anything like TAFE, you can do that as well. So I had to work no matter what. It wasn't a question of taking 4 years off, no work, go and do study. It was doing both. The good thing though was that I could put all of that money towards my living cost as opposed to paying for tuition fees or paying SAF fees. We weren't making a lot of money. There was that government assistance for us as well. Any families, carers in the room will have heard of family tax benefits, childcare subsidies and things like that. I sort of almost relied on that to help me get through. I was getting Austudy and then taking the $1,000 loan from Centrelink as well that you can get every semester. Scholarships and bursaries is just absolute lifesaver. I was lucky enough to be eligible for equity bursaries for a few years of my degree until my workload increased. And that was, you know, $1,000 is how much an equity scholarship is, which is just helps just to pay for just the incidentals that come with studying. There's scholarships for sporting, music, STEM related things, anything technology and science related. There's different sets of scholarships for that as well.
Depending on how much detail you want to go into it, half an hour to an hour is plenty of time to it. I think you've got 200 words to write a little paragraph about yourself. You've got one form, it applies for every single scholarship. Because the scholarship team look at it and use that application and see which one you are eligible for. So you don't have to individually apply for all the different scholarships. If you ever need to talk to one of the coordinators, you just book a meeting, go chat to them, any issues that you have. They really, it's really, really personal. I like the teaching here. Some of you might not have an OP, but that's okay. If you do, you just apply the normal way through QTAC and use your OP to get into university. But if you're non-OP, there are different pathways. So TPP is going to be a great option. So it's a 6-month course, entirely free, and you'll get a rank from that. And then you'll use that rank to apply for the degree that you want to get into. So that will work for the majority of degrees. There are a couple of exceptions there, so just double check. If you've got a TAFE certificate, so certificate 3, 4, or even a diploma, you'll get a rank based on those as well, and you can use that rank to apply into university there. And then if you do identify as Indigenous, we do have a direct entry and access scheme, and you just contact them directly and they'll work through the process with you there. But if you ever need any help with the application process, Student Central is a good start, and then we can help you from there. For me, it's not so much just coming to university and studying, it's a lot more social. So we've got the study groups, and you surround yourself with people who are very like-minded, wanting to do well, and that kind of brings the whole group up together. But yeah, talk to the staff, there's heaps of them out there, lots of information, and the students as well.